Last week, we saw two trials go in favor of a death sentence.
And this is directly connected to the Parkland shooting and the 17 people killed there, along with the gunman who's now serving life in prison. Week News reporter Maddie Herron takes a deeper dive into the changes in the Florida state law.
He massacred 17 people, and now Nicholas Cruz sits in prison with no chance of the death penalty. His jury didn't come to a unanimous decision. Life in prison angered countless people, including Governor Ron DeSantis, who personally pushed for a change in state law, which now only requires 8 out of the 12 jurors to agree. A change that now means these killers, Joseph Zieler, Wade Wilson, and Zephen Xaver, face the death penalty.
Losing a loved one to murder.
I'll never be the person that I was before my mother was murdered.
A nightmare many families suffered in 2018 when Nicholas Cruz killed 17 people inside a Parkland high school. Today, he sits in prison, alive, with no chance at the death penalty. At the time, a Florida state law required a jury to unanimously recommend the death penalty. 9 jurors pushed for his execution, 3 didn't, saving Cruz from death row.
All 12 would have to vote for death, otherwise there wouldn't be a death recommendation.
Public defense attorney Kevin Shirley said the Parkland shooting was the trigger for change. Upset with Cruz's sentence, Governor Ron DeSantis signed a bill in May of 2023, making an 8-4 majority rule the new Florida standard in capital punishment.
Parkland were tried under the current circumstances. That defendant would, there would have been a recommendation of death in that case.
A 9-3 vote in favor of the death penalty. 2 recent capital murder trials, Wade Wilson and Zephen Xaver, had the same vote tally, but with a much different outcome.
If the Florida law hadn't changed, we may not be having this conversation today.
Shirley was one of Wilson's attorneys, defending the man who brutally murdered 2 women in Cape Coral in 2019.
9-3, that's pretty close. All we needed was 2 more jurors, and we're into automatic life sentence.
The law may make a death row jury recommendation for killers like Wilson easier. And while that may be a loss for Shirley and other public defenders, many loved ones of murder victims see the new law as a win.
I agree with the change in the law. I like it, not just because of this case, but because it stops deadlocks.
I think the change of the law was necessary. I don't think it should be up to one juror that could make a decision on an entire case because it needed to be 12 and maybe there's one person that held out.
Family members of the 5 women murdered inside a 2019 Sebring bank rejoiced hearing Zephen Xaver, their loved one's killer, recommended to be put to death. A decision only possible with the new 8-4 majority rule.
This legislation is just over a year old, and Florida is already seeing major ripple effects. Public defender Kevin Shirley told Wink News there are changes in the law courts have to take into consideration, such as if it applies to a case that has been delayed from years prior to the new bill. This was a concern in Wilson and Xaver's trials, but both judges upheld current majority rule, sending both killers down a deadlier path. Maddie Herron, Wink News.